Hello there, fellow model makers, and welcome to the second part of my Edward 148 scale F104J ICO build. Last time, we had a look at the kit and did some work on the cockpit tub. It's time to get into the thick of things and start putting together the landing bay subassembly and the engine. As always, the parts are cut and cleaned first. It is always a good idea to dry fit the parts as you move along to ensure that everything lines up properly. There was a minor snag in the engine parts alignment. These guiding pins were not sitting properly in their corresponding slots. So I trimmed them off and lined up the parts without their help. I now used AK's Extreme Metal Black base on the parts. Before I start painting the kit with metal colors, I decided that I must check the various metallic paints I have and see which ones I want to use. A search of the various storage boxes and drawers revealed that I have way more metallic paints than I need. Next, I got a packet of these disposable plastic spoons. Before the testing can commence, I had to black base the spoons. This took two light layers of AK's Extreme Metal Black base. Once the black base was dry, I started testing the paint. I wrote the name of the paint on the inside of the spoon and then airbrushed the paint on the outside. Soon, I had over a dozen spoons painted with various shades of metallic colors. I now checked the reference material to see which paints would look best on the kit. The challenge was this section on the exhaust of the aircraft, which is shinier than the rest of the aircraft. Despite the numerous metallic paints that I have, none of them were able to reproduce a shiny surface like this one. I decided that I would have to use an aluminium foil to get close to this look. After much deliberation, I finally decided to use these two colors for most of the aircraft. Extreme Metals Aluminium for the landing base and the insides of the landing covers, and Tamiya Lacquer Gloss Aluminium for the rest of the aircraft body. For the shiny parts on the exhaust, I would use an aluminium foil. And various darker shades of metallic aluminium and steel for the exhaust. With the choice made, I now airbrushed some extreme metal aluminium on the landing base and the engine. For the darker shade inside the engine, I used Tamiya's XF84 Dark Iron. A few engine parts were painted with extreme metal steel. I also used extreme metal steel to add a little bit of post shading on the landing base. Now, some post shading with pale burnt metal. I hand painted some of the wiring and pipes in the landing bay with various colors. Now a layer of Mr. Color Clear to protect the work so far. I used Tamiya's black panel line accent color for the wash. I now use a cotton bud moistened with odorless spirit to wipe away any extra wash. The engine assembly was now glued together. The next step was to drill holes for various navigational and landing lights that go on the fuselage. I airbrushed aluminium from the inside on the lights to give them a more natural look. The kit comes with poly caps for the landing gear joints. I think this is a very good idea, as this is a much sturdier joint than using glue at the end of the build. Also, one can attach the landing gear temporarily during the build if one needs to do so. It's time now to glue all the parts inside the fuselage halves. I glue the cockpit tub to one side of the fuselage. I close the second half of the fuselage, but I do not glue it. This ensures that even though the part is being glued to only one side of the fuselage, it is correctly aligned. The fact that the parts are only glued to one side also leaves margin for me to make adjustments to the part's position in case required. I now do the same for all the parts that will go inside the fuselage halves. I use masking tape to fit the two halves together. Once the parts are firmly glued to one side of the fuselage, I apply glue to the surface on the other side and glue the fuselage halves together. The landing gear piece is now glued in place. While gluing the large parts together, like the fuselage halves here, I often find that some fine alignment is required. To do this, I sometimes make a temporary rig using cocktail sticks and tape, or rubber band sometimes. This presses down on the part and helps align the seam better. Here I am using the sticks to press down on the left side of the fuselage to help it line up. I now turn my attention to the nose section, which comes in two parts. I think I'm not alone when I say I prefer the nose section to be a single piece. Anyway, I glue the two parts together. Once the cement had cured, I sanded out the seam line. I also sanded down some other seams on the fuselage. Now I rescribe the lost panel lines and rivets. To add weight to the nose, I pour in some liquid gravity and then fix it in place with super glue. A few other remaining pieces, like the air intakes, are given a coat of black base. Part of these intakes will remain black, so I mask them off before painting them with extreme metal aluminium. Next, I clean and glue the tail assembly and the wings in place. The last sub-assembly that I will put together for now are the wing-mounted fuel tanks. I will not attach them to the wings though, to make painting them easier. Right then, fellow model makers, there is plenty more to do with this kit. But we are out of time on this edition. I hope you are enjoying the build. If you are, please do click the like button. Do subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. I will be back soon with part 3 of the build. Till then, stay safe, good luck, and happy model making.